I've done my research, and now I'm back to tell you about the Eustachian tube. And I'll show you how it's spelled. Eustachian, Eustachian tube. And it connects the middle ear, this part, down into the back of your nose and mouth. And when you're on the airplane, there's sort of muscles here, muscles in this area that need to open up to allow the air in this part to equalize with the outside air. And when that happens and it equalizes, that's when you hear the pop and suddenly you can hear better. Or, it might have sounded a little muffled before because the eardrum was under pressure. In the drum metaphor, if you have pumped up the drum full of air, it won't be able to vibrate as well, and your eardrum won't vibrate as well. If it's not equalized, you won't be able to hear as well. So some people have control over these muscles, and they can pop it without having to yawn or swallow or anything. They can just leave them open. But usually chewing gum on the airplane can help with if you have discomfort or whatever. And the Eustachian tube isn't super important to psychology. You're probably not going to see it in psych class, but I didn't want to leave you hanging. So that's what it does. It connects the middle ear only to the nose and mouth.